Here I can see part of the duodenum. This is part of the C shape of the duodenum. Second and third part. Okay, you can see it here. Second and third part. They are located retroperitoneally, but I have removed part of the peritoneum of the infracolic compartment. And within the C, this yellowish-whitish structure is the head of the pancreas. And the superior mesenteric vessels are arising from behind the head of the pancreas in the front of the uncinate process. This is the uncinate process of the pancreas. In the front of it is the superior mesenteric vessels, and where the mesentery of the small intestine is also attached here, and these vessels will gain access to the mesentery of the small intestine. Here is the jejunum. You can see the mesentery here containing blood vessels, which have the blood vessels here are having fewer arcades, but the long vasa recta. But you can see the vasa recta easily because of the smaller amount of fat. This is the region of the ileum. You can see, and this is the cecum. So I'm very close to the cecum. This is the ileum here. So evidently, I can now feel, maybe you can see that as well. This is thicker wall, jejunum is thicker wall. This is very thin and compressed. And it is difficult to see the vessels. It's not easy to see the vessels as we see them here, because there is an extra amount of fat, excess amount of fat in the mesentery of the ileum. But if you will be able to see the vessels, you will find that they have more arcades and less vasa recta. Okay? And again, I will remind you that the wall of the jejunum is thick. It's as if it has a double wall because of the excessive amount of plicae circularis, which are mucosal, submucosal folds, which are excessively present in the jejunum, and they wane gradually toward the ileum. Okay? And I will try to orient you to start with. This is the stomach with the greater curvature and the lesser curvature. And this is the duodenum, the C shape of the duodenum. And within the C shape is the head of the pancreas, body and tail of the pancreas. I will follow the tail of the pancreas until we reach the spleen. So this is the spleen. Here is the spleen, okay, and the tail of the pancreas. And then this is the jejunum, and then the ileum with the mesentery, okay? Here at the pyloric region, pyloric sphincter, it is very clear the thickening of the muscle fibers, the smooth muscle fibers in the wall of the stomach. So this is the region of the pyloric sphincter. Now I am going into the duodenum, the first part of a duodenum. It's a smooth. This is the beginning of the first part of a duodenum, which is called the duodenal cap also by radiologists. It's the site where peptic ulceration most likely occur. And then the inside, the rest of the duodenum, you can see that it is folded. Circular folds, very clear, plicae circularis. In the middle of the second part of the duodenum, and on the posteromedial wall of it, this is the papilla, the major duodenal papilla, this one. Okay? Major duodenal papilla. In the middle of the second part of the duodenum, on its posteromedial wall. And this is the opening of the ampulla of water, which is the union of the bile duct and the major pancreatic duct. Here's the third part of the duodenum. You can see the third part of the duodenum is crossed by the superior mesenteric vessels. Again, here, this is the jejunum. It's opened. You can see the plicae circularis, a lot of plicae circularis here. And look at the mesentery. Fewer amount of fat, long vasa recta, only one arcades, is a group of arcades is present. If we go to the ileum, more distally, like in here, so there are less plicae circularis, as you can see if you compare it with the, and it is thinner wall. This is the jejunum, more plicae circularis, ileum, less plicae circularis, and there's more fat And probably I can show you the arcades, some of them. See, there are some lymph nodes. Can you see the lymph nodes as well? These are lymph nodes. They look like beads here. The beaded structures are the lymph nodes, which are located in the mesentery. And yeah, now I can show you some of the arcades. Yes, you can see here that there is more than one group of arcades before giving the vasa recta. So the vasa recta are shorter than those of the jejunum.